Do you want to learn how to implement Pagination with the Paging3 library in your Android Jetpack Compose app? Then stay tuned. Hi guys, my name is Anne Greis. I hope you're doing well and I welcome you to a new video. In general, when loading data, you have for example one SQL query and load all your data from your Android Room database. However, if you have a large data set, that can get quickly very inefficient. One way to overcome this problem is using Pagination. With Pagination, you don't load all your data at once, but in smaller chunks. So for example, you have 1,000 items in your database and you incrementally load your data in steps of 10 items, for example. That way we can spare the user loading animations and so on and can directly show the data to them. Paging3 is Google's solution for Android apps to implement Pagination. While it is very handy, at the first glance it can be a little bit overwhelming, but no worries, in this video we will take a look at a practical example where we take a look at a one-shot loading screen, so where all the data is loaded at once, and then we will see from the bottom up how we can use Pagination to improve this process. In Android Studio, we are here in the app module build gradle file, and as you can see, we have two dependencies that are important for Paging3. So at this point, I assume that you have successfully set up your project for Jetpack Compose. And now if you want to use Paging3, you just have to include the runtime and also the Paging Compose dependency. Note that this is a release candidate version, but I use it here because it aligns together. And previously, the Paging Compose dependency was still misaligned with the version numbers of the runtime. So let's directly look at a practical example. Here we have an articles overview screen. So we have some kind of articles that at some point came from a backend and got stored in our local Android Room database. To show all articles to the user, we now want to load those articles from the database. We can also do that for example, offline support. As you can see, here is this one-shot approach. So all the articles get loaded at once, and then we just show the articles in a lazy column here and use the items here from the lazy column scope. Finally, we have an simple article item composable here that just shows those articles. So how does one article look like? So simple structure, this is a domain representation. And of course, we also have a database representation. And as you can see, very simple and straightforward. Title, abstract, which is just a short description of the article, content and author. So our final goal is now to stop loading all the data at once and instead use Pagination. We do that from a bottom-up approach and start with the data access object. So now inside the article DAO, as you can see, we still have here the load all articles function, which is currently used by the current approach of loading data. And now instead of retrieving a list of article entities, we want to receive a so-called paging source. So let's quickly replace that. Say here instead, load all articles paged, for example, and then we want to use a paging source. And here we now need to put in a key and a value. And the key represents essentially the index of our data source. In our case, we have pages and those pages are stored by an ID, which is in our case an integer. So it's incremental, that means page one, page two, and so on. So we use an integer, and our value here is of course our article entity. Next up, as you can see, we're here inside the articles repository, and now there's nothing more to do than replacing here the new function. And of course, here we also want to return the paging source. And now we can also adapt this function name here, load all articles paged, for example, once again. And we are done for this part. So now that we migrated already the data layer, let's proceed to the domain layer. And here actually comes the interesting part of this whole process. We have here a use case that is called get all articles paged use case. And you can see we have here the articles repository. And now we want to write a function that returns a flow, but the flow is not directly of our articles, but of a paging data. And here we have the domain representation of the article. And what this paging data represents is essentially all the data that already got loaded from our paging source. So to finally return this flow, we first need to create a new pager, and inside we need a paging config. And this paging config can be created by providing a page size, and we can simply say page size 10. And we can also set a prefetch distance. And this prefetch distance is essentially what gets loaded at the first occurrence or retrieval of this source here. But don't get it wrong, it's not about the page itself, how many pages we are prefetching, but about the items. So if you go inside here, as you can see, the initial or default value here for is the page size. Now let's say we want to load 20 items instead, and yeah, essentially we're good to go. Of course, you have also some more configuration options here, like enabling placeholders, which is enabled by default, and also the max size or jump threshold. Next up, we need to provide our paging source, which we already tunneled through the data layer to the articles repository. So we can now just say here, articles repository, load all articles paged. And now we just need to call here flow and are already returning paging data of article entities. But what we actually want to have here is the domain representation. So let's quickly call here map. And what we now receive is, as an input parameter, the value, which is of paging data. And now we can use a special function of this paging data here called map. And inside, so once again map, and inside we can actually access the respective item here. So let's say article entity, and I have here a mapping function that maps to the domain model, and we are good to go. Next up, we are inside the articles overview model, and here we just need to introduce the use case we just created, and then we can migrate this little example here, and we say articles paged data. And then we access here the view use case, and additionally use the cache in function to actually preserve the loaded data. And we need to put in here the view model scope. So if a configuration change of your application happens, for example, through rotating the device, your last state of the page data will be preserved and it's not fetched from its initial state again. So let's quickly also add the type here. You can see it's of the paging data article. And let's proceed to the last step, converting the composable. So here back in the articles overview screen composable, let's go and start converting this example to use pagination. And it's not that complicated. We can simply say here, for this case, we don't need a state because it's only an example. So we can say articles, lazy paging items, and then we can access the view model, our flow, and then we say collect as lazy paging items, which comes from the paging compose dependency. So once again, let's add the type here. And now we can quickly migrate that. So let's also name that to articles lazy paging items, input the variable here, and then we can also adapt the type here. And next up, we need to adapt the lazy color. And here it gets a little bit weird, but don't worry, because we now no longer directly insert items, but we use a count and then access here the articles lazy page items with the item count. And next up, we need a key. And here we can once again access it and use here the item key. And yeah, just insert our identifier here. So we can once again name that here also to article. And then the next thing you might also want to add is the content type. And here you can also use a little helper from this type here. So just say item content type. And then you can just say, for example, articles. And yeah, the last thing we need to insert here is the, or create is the actual composable, which refers to the respective item. So here we just retrieve the article from the articles lazy paging items, and we can use an array accessor here and say index. So as you can see, this value here is nullable. So let's say if this article is not null, we can simply show our article item and are fine. And even if it's not worth much, here is our example. And as you can see, I can scroll and scroll, and the paging source automatically loads the further pages when it hits a threshold of items that are currently visible on the screen. So in this video, we saw how we can use the Paging3 library in combination with Android Room and Jetpack Compose. Are you interested in looking deeper into the Paging3 library and exploring the capabilities? Did you already have a use case for Pagination in an Android app? And if so, did you use Paging3 or another solution? Let me know in the comments. As always, I hope you had some takeaways. Like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, activate the notification bell, and I hope to see you soon.